swinging for the fences. It's like this heart is defenseless against a passion that's pumping through my veins. Blood, sweat, tears, it's a calling. And if I can't walk, then I'm crawling. It might flicker, but they can't kill the flame.
Transformation. 10 days, I know what you're thinking, that's not a lot of time, but my effort and my point here is to show you that even through the holidays, even when things are sometimes unplanned, and even though we have a lot going on in our personal lives, we can still stay committed to our goals. I'm going to talk about a few things that are really important when trying to reach your goals and remain health conscious through the holidays. I truly believe that living in the moment and, you know, obviously cherishing memories that you have with your family, friends, loved ones through this joyful time of year. However, sometimes it's easy to go overboard, okay? And then you're stuck on January 2nd wondering what the heck happened. Am I right? Happened to me too before. So, without further ado, I'm going to show you my physique. Very transparent video today. I'm allowing myself to be vulnerable. I'm a lot heavier than I was a few months ago when I competed in bodybuilding. So it's kind of difficult for me to show you all this, but the first physique that I'm going to show you was a day or two before Thanksgiving. And then the physique I'm going to show you after is 10 days later. In total, I lost 4.5 pounds. And throughout that 10 days, I participated in all of the festivities. I had cookies, chocolate pretzels, couple turkey dinners with my families. So I had a lot of treats, but I kept a few things in mind, and it helped me stay diligent in reaching my goals. Like I said, 4 pounds isn't a lot, but in regards to what time of the year it is, obviously making marginal changes. I'm not trying to do anything crazy right now in regards to my goals. I'm simply trying to cut a little bit of fat and get in a more comfortable place just for my own sake and for my athleticism, for my competition. I'm looking too far taken. Early this in 2020, I am trying to get down to a lower weight class, just a smidge. So, talk about what you should do in order to stay focused and stay steadfast in what you're trying to achieve, whatever that may be. These 10 days, to be honest, this was really an accountability thing for me. It allowed me to be honest with myself. I knew I was going to vlog this and share this with you guys and be vulnerable, so I knew that I wanted to stay focused and control the controllables, okay? So I made all my workouts. I did no extra cardio here. There is no cardio involved in this 10-day transformation, but there was one yoga session and my strength training regimen, which I, you know, programmed for myself. And so I just made all my workouts and pushed through and made sure I was focused in that regard. So a few things that you can do when it comes to the holidays to keep your health in mind through the holidays, there's a few things. Number one is drink your water. Drink your water, okay? 9 times out of 10, all of our problems come from being thirsty, figuratively and literally, okay? It's recommended that you drink about 8 ounces of water. Water a day, that's about 2 liters, about a half gallon. And if you're an athlete, you should drink even more than that. All of my clients that I program a fitness routine for, I recommend you drink 1 gallon of water a day. Also, when you are keeping in mind your water intake. The first thing you should do when you wake up is sippy sip sip on some water. Before you hit the coffee, before you hit any morning treats, drink some water, get your muscle, your body flowing, your organs moving in there, pushing things around, moving things around, get your metabolism started. And even if you feel frisky, throw a lemon in there, okay? So drink your water and drink a lot of it, especially when you're pumping yourself full of sodium-induced ham and turkey. Drink the water, okay? That's number one. Number two is move your body. Okay, I understand. I'm not talking about lifting weights. I'm not talking about going to yoga. I'm not talking about going to a CrossFit gym. I'm not talking about getting nuts, okay? I'm talking about simply moving your feet. I recommend having a daily step goal in mind. I have an Apple Watch. There's a lot of less expensive watches out there or trackers, fitness trackers. I recommend having a goal in mind when it comes to steps per day to see how much you're moving. And also, when you're not moving, you can be like, maybe I should go for a walk or my lunch break before I go to the Krispy Kreme. Okay? So keep a step goal in mind. I attempt to hit 10,000 steps per day. So if I'm short, I don't always make that. I do focus more on strength training versus cardio or walking and running and all of that. But if for some reason I'm really short for the day, if I had a really busy day in my office and I'm sitting and I'm stagnant and I'm sedentary for hours on end, I try to walk a little bit more. I try to take my dogs for a longer walk, and I may throw an extra 5 or 10 minutes of cardio in there after my strength training. So if you want to make a step goal for 5,000 to 10,000 steps per day and just focus on that, even if you're out of town for the holidays or busy with parties, make sure you are moving your feet. Don't just sit there and let that food sit. Eat all the food. No movement. It's not good. Okay, Susan. That's number two. Number three is allow yourself some grace. I preach on preparation, on having a plan, fail to prepare, prepare to fail, blah, blah, blah. That is when it comes to reaching serious goals and wanting to accomplish something that is out of this world huge. But when it comes to simply maintaining and not letting the holiday treats get the best of us, allow yourself some grace. What that means is if you have a white elephant Christmas party at noon and you got to be the Grandma Judy's by 3 and you have no time, you're already busy getting the kids in the car, getting the husband around, doing all the things that you got to do, and you simply don't have time to work out, allow yourself some grace and put that plan out the window and do some burpees in the living room, okay? Do some squats with your baby in your arms. Whatever you can do to move your body, it doesn't have to be perfect. There just has to be effort. Your best is always enough. So if that means simply doing a 10-minute to 15-minute yoga workout from YouTube's on the TV because you ain't got no time, you tell me I ain't got no time, you know, I ain't even started Christmas shopping, it's December 12th, I ain't started. Then do what you can, allow yourself some grace, and understand that if you are trying and you're putting a little bit of effort every day, sometimes our 75% is our 100% that day. And that's just the way the cookie crumbles. So do what you can, allow yourself some grace. And the last thing that I want to talk about is stress. No stranger to stress. I come from a family of warriors. My anxiety is more times than not through the roof. However, stress, hormones, cortisol, all of those are very real things. And unless you can manage what's going on in here, okay, it's not going to be conducive to what's going on in here. So what you need to do is focus on, even though it's the holidays and I know it's stressful, focus on what you can control, let go of what you can't. Focus on relaxing when you can. Take a couple extra bubble baths, okay? Decompress off your phone. Don't be worrying about who bought what, your friend Carol, what she bought her kid, okay, on Facebook. Put your phone away, relax, okay? Maybe go get a massage, do something nice for yourself. Manage your stress levels, because stress levels can seriously hinder your progress in any avenue of fitness, whatever you are trying to do at any level. If you are constantly stressed out and worrying, stop it. Knock it off. You stop it, okay? Just relax. It's all gonna be okay. Everything is gonna be okay. So those are 4 things that you can do to remain health conscious through the holidays. I hope hope this helped you, even just a little bit. If it did, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button, my friends. Like I said in previous videos and my other social media platforms, Chris and I are really going to utilize YouTube in 2020. We have serious goals, ideas, visions, things we want to accomplish together. And of course, being the people that we are, we of course want to share it with you. So make sure you're subscribed. If you think someone could benefit from this, let them know about our channel. We really, our main purpose is to encourage with purpose. Okay, we want to encourage you to get out there and do what you were made to do and show you that you are more than mediocre. I love you guys so much. I hope you have a wonderful day. It is only 7 a.m. You wouldn't know it. And my fiance is singing a song at 7 a.m. See, we're made for each other. I love you guys so much. Have a wonderful day. And just never forget that you are worthy and you are capable. God loves you. I love you. And we're going to crush our goals even through the holidays. But just keep in mind what the holidays are all about. We already know. Okay, we already know. I love you guys so much.